think so?
Yes.
All right. Jump up.
Daddy, don't go in the sharp blade.
Jump up.
Daddy, we're getting the sharp blade.
Okay, you're gonna have to put that away or I can't read to you, okay?
Okay. I'll put it right here.
You can.
Number squish squish is right here.
I did not understand that.
Number squish squish and nobody's gonna see it.
Alright, this is where we are. Okay, chapter 6. Chapter 7. Button pusher. Okay, you're gonna leave that alone. Yeah, okay. Chapter 7, button pusher. Whoosh! The door flipped shut and all the buttons on the control panel started blinking wildly. Beep, whir, zoop, 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 zoop. The spaceship came to life. Dudley jumped up to his feet and screamed, "What's happening?" "Calm down, silly," said Max. "We're just hiding. It's not like the spaceship is going to blast off into space." "Hello, space explorers." But then a pixelated voice appeared on the screen and said, "Hello, space explorers. Please secure your safety belts and prepare to blast off into
space.
Good one. Henry ran his hands through his hair and said, "Prepare to what?" "We'd better buckle up," said Max as she reached for her safety belt. But Henry and Dudley were too busy pushing as many buttons on the control panel as they could. "We have to stop this thing," Dudley cried. Henry pushed the big red button again with the heel of his hand. "Maybe this will reverse what Max did," he said. But instead, numbers started counting down on the screen. "Time remaining, 5 seconds," the spaceship announced. 4, 5, 4. Henry and Dudley stumbled back into the seats beside Max and strapped themselves in. 3, 2, 1, blast off. The spaceship shuddered and as it lifted off, the kids watched the screen in disbelief. The spaceship hurled out of the Earth's atmosphere. Blue skies had given way to the darkness of outer space.
Why?
Is there any air in space?
No.
"Wow," Max exclaimed. "The stars seem so close." Henry and Dudley stared at Max, who seemed to have no idea what she had done. The stars are close," Henry barked. "Because if you hadn't noticed, we're in outer space." Chapter 8, Out of This World. "Destination, Moon," the spaceship announced. Dudley gulped. "Oh, isn't that a little far from home?" Max giggled and covered her mouth. "That's not funny," Dudley snapped. What if we can't get back to Earth?" Max shrugged. "Well, we can always be space spies." Dudley's jaw dropped wide open. He was about to ask Max what was going on when the spaceships started talking again. "Did you know that 1,000,000 Earths could fit inside the sun?" Henry smacked his head with the palm of his hand. "No one cares, spaceship," he screamed. "Just turn us around." Max studied the control panel. "It can't be that hard to fly this thing," she said. "Let's see if this button helps." Max pushed a yellow button and the spaceship shook and shifted directions. Uh-oh, looks like rocks in space.
"You have now entered a meteor shower," the spaceship said. "Meteors may cause damage to the spacecraft."
Loud alarms started blaring in the ship. A screen lit up to show hundreds of meteors headed right for them. "Is this dangerous?"
"Yes."
"Change course," shouted Henry. "Let's shut
He shut his eyes and wished for his magic book. The book always showed up in times of trouble, but when Henry opened his eyes, all he saw were more meteors. The drawer slid open next to Dudley. There was a controller inside with buttons and arrows, like a video game controller. Maybe we can use this to get home, Dudley suggested. Or we could push another button, said Max. The boys jumped in front of Max and said, no! See their hands?
No!
Why?
They don't want her to push any more buttons. The spaceship spoke up again.
Did you know the Earth is 238,900 miles from the moon?
Be quiet, spaceship, the boys shouted at the same time. And that's when Max grabbed the controller from Dudley and pushed another button. Zaroop! The spaceship lurched forward toward the meteors. The boys covered their eyes. Max laughed again and pushed another button. The alarms stopped as the spaceship swirled and headed toward a blue-green planet.
Destination Earth, the spaceship announced.
Henry and Dudley sighed in relief. Let's just hope the spaceship goes back to Brewster, he said.
Dude, Max said, just relax and enjoy the ride.
Henry glanced sideways at his friend. She seemed a little too calm about everything. As they re-entered the Earth's atmosphere, the spaceship slowed down.
Space explorers, prepare for landing.
The kids gripped their safety belts, squeezed their eyes shut, and waited for touchdown. Chapter 9. It's back. The spaceship landed with a jolt. Come. As the pixelated face appeared on the screen again.
Welcome to Earth, and thanks for flying the cosmic skies.
Max unclipped her harness and hopped out of her seat. Well, that was a wild ride, she said.
I mean, how could the day get any weirder?
The others got up, too, as the spaceship door glided open again. And there, standing in plain sight, was the fuzzy green alien.
Oh my gosh, Henry whispered. It's the alien!
Dudley stood still, unable to move. Then he said,
we come in peace.
But Max wasn't surprised at all. Instead, she started laughing uncontrollably.
Henry, Dudley, she said. That's just my mom.
Henry and Dudley looked at each other in shock.
If that's your mom, then that means you're an alien, asked Dudley.
Now Max was rolling on the floor with a full-blown fit of the giggles.
What is going on here?
Asked Henry. Then the alien pulled off its head and revealed a blonde woman who looked a lot like Max.
I can explain, the woman said. I actually am Max's mom, and I work as a scientist at the Space Center.
I'm also Orby, the Space Center's new alien character. And this isn't a real spaceship. It's a new ride called Orby's Orbitron, and you three were the first to ride it.
What do you think?
Max stood back up and hugged her mom. They were both scared out of their minds, she said.
But it felt so real, said Henry. It was like we were actually flying in space.
Max's mom smiled, and said, perfect. That's the way it was supposed to feel.
Since my mom works here, we were invited to be the first ones to try the new ride, Max explained.
Everyone knew about it except you guys. Henry shook his head.
You planned this whole thing? The alien arms? The curtains? The spaceship?
Max nodded, and Henry drew in a deep breath.
Well, thanks, he said, because it was totally out of this world. And super scary, Dudley added. I loved every minute of it. Then everyone laughed. Chapter 10, Space Puppets. Dudley, Henry, and Max had gotten hungry in space. They ran back to the food lab and ate their lunches. Mrs. Mapplethorpe gave them alien gummies for dessert. After lunch, they joined the rest of the class in the rocket garden. The class climbed inside rockets and lunar modules. Mrs. Mizzle took a picture of Henry, Dudley, and Max beside a rocket. Then the class visited the gift shop. It had space board games, space puzzles, space playing cards, even space puppets. Henry picked up an alien puppet. So Max, he said, working the puppet's mouth and using an alien voice, do you believe in aliens or not? Max slipped on a space monkey puppet.
Ee-ee-oop-oop-oop-oop-ee-ee-oop,
squeaked Max in the space monkey talk. I can't say for sure, but I do believe in Astro Buddies, and I know one named Henry Heckelbeck, and he has a big secret. Henry gulped. Did Max know about his magic?
What kind of secret?
Henry asked his puppet. Just that you're actually an alien in disguise and were sent to spy on my friend Max, the most normal human being on Earth, Max said with her puppet. Then Dudley slipped on an Astro Bear puppet and made it talk.
I don't know what's funnier. Max, what do you think, Henry's an alien or that you think you're normal?
The three friends cracked up and flung the space puppets back in the bin. As they lined up to get back on the bus to school, Henry held his hand out to Dudley and said, here's to space, friends, he said. Dudley and Max piled on their hands on top of Henry's. To space, friends, they shouted. And to aliens, added Henry, putting his hand back on top. To aliens, they shouted.
Meet me.
That's it. I'm gonna just put this back on the shelf. Sir. No, I just need to put it back on the shelf. Right, excuse me, sir. That was long. I just read like 5 or 6 chapters. That was long.
Yeah.
Okay.
Daddy.
Yes? Do you want to talk to these Knuckles?
Daddy?
Do you want to talk to the Knuckles?
Yes, Luke. What do you want to say, Luke? Yes?
All right. Do you want to keep this in bed?
Yes.
All right, come on. Definitely not.
Why?
Well, because that makes the spaceship start and take off into space. Lay down. Do you want this blanket with the corners?
Yes.
Do you want that weighted blanket? Lay down.